Hello, to run a finite element analysis FEA on a 3D part, first let's open NX into a FEMAP. For doing so, you go to File, New, and you do File, Import, Geometry. Then you will choose any part that you want to open. In this case, I'm going to open a frame that was done originally in Pro E. Once the part opens up, now we will go ahead and define the properties for the part from menu, model, property. We will be assigning a property type to it. We are gonna, in the plane elements, I'm gonna assign plate. And then for title, remember what you put in the title here, because later on you will be using the same title in another part of the same process. We are going to give it a thickness of 0.1. Okay, and then here where it says material 0 does not exist, we want to say yes. And now we will load from a library a steel. I'm giving it a entry for the steel. Hit OK. 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 And then here we hit cancel to exit out. Now to mesh the model, we need to choose two adjacent regions. I'm going to use this area as well as this one. To do so, we go to Geometry, Boundary Surface, and From Curves. Now I am ready to select the boundaries for the first region. As you see, it turned color, and I'm just zooming in, selecting the boundaries. After selecting the boundaries for the first one, you notice that there is a circle that appears in the middle of them, showing that the boundaries was before the region was selected. So that goes for the first one. We hit OK and hit OK again. So this one, I'm gonna hit this one, this edge, and this edge. Now we can hit OK and cancel. So now we can go ahead and mesh what we just defined. Under mesh menu, we will choose mesh control and size on the surface. Size on the surface. So I will do select all and hit OK. And now for the element size, I can choose 0.3, hit OK, and cancel to exit. Now I'm going to do the same thing for the by going through the menu, mesh, geometry, surface. Now go ahead and mouse over somewhere in the middle of the region that you selected. Like if you go mouse over, this goes by trial and error that you will figure out. Okay, so right now you see the whole boundary is selected. I'm going to select somewhere in the middle of it and hit OK. And more options here for the property. I'm going to enter shell. This is where you had entered before, the title, where you had entered in the previous dialog box. This is exactly what you're choosing from this pull down menu. And uncheck this one that says connect edge nodes, and then you hit OK. From the menu, mesh, geometry, surface, go ahead and select the second region. That's the region that is has a common boundary with the first one that you defined, that you selected. Hit OK and OK. So now you see the two adjacent regions have a mesh on it to display duplicate nodes. There may be duplicate nodes along the common area. We need to go through View, Select, and under Model Style, go ahead and select Free Edges and hit OK. Back to Menu, under Tools, check Coincident Nodes, student notes. Here we do select all, okay, and what this is gonna do is to merge the common notes that there was. So action is gonna be merge, keep ID automatic, move to current location, okay, and then under menu window regenerate. Once you regenerate, we go to view select. In view select we can say for model style we will say draw model, okay, and now we are ready to apply constraints and loads on the model. If you find this video informative, go ahead and join, subscribe, and if you have any comments and constructive criticism, please add it to the comment area. Thank you.